This is a Gear Network production.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's your boy, Mr. Perez, and you're listening to the Better Live Than Dead podcast brought to you exclusively on Gear Network. Listen in.
Welcome to episode number 42 of the Better Live Than Dead podcast.
Episode 42, peoples.
I'm your host, Ryan Wolf. My other host, co-host. We're co-hosts.
Co-host.
Half of a host. Ryan Wolf, Mr. Perez.
Sup, peoples.
Hanging out here. A beautiful day in Western New York so far.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's a little overcast. It's not real sunny, but it's warm.
Well, it's supposed to rain on and off today.
That's fine.
But
I'm going someplace today. I got to work.
They're talking 90 today.
Yeah. Well, it was 91 yesterday in Ithaca when I was out there.
I got in my car and it was 90. It said 99 in my car. I mean, it went down, but it was...
Yeah, my car...
It's nice to see that, you know?
My car at one point read like 101, and I was like, yeah, this is a lie.
It's nice to see. So, also, hey, Leicester City just went up 2-0.
Good for job, Leicester City.
They're trying to avoid relegation.
Relegation sucks.
Yeah. First year in the Premier League, and they could become the first team... I think that's the first team ever in the Premier League. They were last place on Christmas.
Right.
And they may end up missing relegation.
Right.
Be the first team ever to do that.
That would be good for them.
Because obviously, for people who don't watch soccer, bottom three teams in the Premier League go to the Champions.
Right.
I think it's Champions League or Champions.
Yeah.
Whatever
it's called. I think it's the Champions League.
They go down to the second tier. Then the winner of that moves up.
Right.
And two other people move up or whatever. I'm still getting the grasp on it. Either way, Leicester City, please keep winning because I want to watch Premier League soccer for another year at least.
You ever been to Ithaca?
No.
Their tagline is, it's gorgeous, because there's a lot of gorges there.
You know what reminds me of Ithaca is the movie Road Trip.
Really?
I think they filmed it in Ithaca.
Did they?
I think so.
Maybe. I don't know. I have to look that up. But, for what I do in my job, I'll go to Elmira first, then I drive the 40 minutes over to Ithaca, hit my stores there, then drive home. So Ithaca's tagline is it's gorgeous because of the gorges in the area. But dude, listen, I may have you ride with me one day so you can come check out Ithaca with me.
Sounds good.
Because it's college town.
Oh.
And with this type of weather,
oh,
the college people.
I know where you're going with this. If you travel through Brockport, it's the same thing. I mean, I'm sure Ithaca is a lot nicer.
But as someone who's gone to Brockport, the quality is not the same as in Ithaca. Like, dude, I was literally rolling down the street yesterday, like 5 miles an hour. Enjoying.
Got your four ways on, just rolling in.
Bro, got my sunroof open, smoking a cigar, enjoying the sights. It was ridiculous. Ridiculous yesterday. So, Ithaca, thank you for that.
Maybe we'll have to go to Ithaca sometime.
Oh, bro.
I'll tell you what, speaking of the beautiful weather, I was seriously probably, if I didn't have to go anywhere today, because obviously when you leave, you know, I can take care of everything myself, but I was fairly close to putting the podcast outside today.
It would have been fun, dude. I got a couple cigars in the car.
Maybe we could do that next week or something. Or next time it's hot out, because I don't know when it's going to be 90 degrees again, but
because
it's supposed to be in the upper 50s, low 60s the next week or so.
Yeah, but I
but
think
even if it's, even
next
if it's,
weekend it's supposed to go back into the 80s.
Well, even if it's 60 degrees outside, I'm still there.
Right.
If the sun's on, give a damn.
Well, you know, hey, John, if you hear this, which I know you will, if we do it outside, I have some cigars, just come over.
Actually, that's a good point. Maybe next, actually, I think I got to talk to you because I think, not next Saturday, but the Saturday after. One of these Saturdays, I want to do a night podcast.
Okay, whatever.
But maybe we could do it outside.
All right. Speaking of cigars, bro, listen, I want to send props out to your brother, Eric. He sent over an updated version of the logo for the Smoke Productions, and it's cherry.
It looks real good.
It looks real good.
He actually said, I didn't want to say anything to you, but he sent me the logo right when he sent it to you.
Okay.
And I was like, dude, I got to have it. Like, I have to have it. And that's the same thing I told you. I was like, I need a shirt that... I don't even care if you make one shirt. I need a shirt that says that, because that's
right.
Awesome. But obviously, once you get the logos, once you pay for them, we'll get Beyond the Smoke's Facebook page all popped up and Twitter page and everything taken care of.
Yeah, one of the guys was like, yo, I had your money last night, but you weren't here. And I was like...
Why don't you get my money today?
Right. He was like, I bought a bottle of bourbon.
Oh. Okay. That's a good reason, though.
Yeah, I can get with that. But,
Well, the logos aren't going anywhere. They're not going to disintegrate or get sold to somewhere else.
Yeah, I know, but I'd like to get, you know, I'd like to get them as soon as possible.
Absolutely.
You get know, so started. I can get well, stuff
I think,
going.
I think nobody has, besides a few of us, have seen the Smoke Productions logo yet.
Right.
That's going to look really nice on a Facebook banner.
It is.
On a Facebook cover photo.
Yeah, and I actually have a, which one did he send you? Do you have a picture of the one he sent
I
you?
I have the one with the leaf. There's a leaf on it.
So well, yes, but there was two of them. There was a lighter version and then a darker version. Because I think I sent you the darker version.
I don't know, honestly. I deleted the text message.
Because the darker version was the one I really liked. So he has applied a couple filters to make it look a little darker. It actually feels like looking into a humidor, which is what I really like.
That's cool.
Yeah.
So it's funny because he was talking to me about it and he goes, it's interesting to work with Perez. And I said, why is that? He goes, because I'm trying to get, because obviously whenever you work with somebody when it comes to graphics, I've been around him long enough to know you kind of have to get into their head.
Right.
But some people, it's a little harder than others.
Right.
So he's taking some time, but I think he finally got, he got into your head.
Getting into my head is hard.
Well, I think he finally did it because, you know, he's like, well, Perez likes it, but I was waiting for it because he's like, Perez likes it, but, and I'm like, okay, that's what I was waiting for. And he's like, but he wants me to change some things on it. And now he texts me and he goes, Perez likes this one. And I'm like, damn, you did it.
Well, you know, what's funny is that he sent me one. I'll show you the one that he sent me that I really liked. So this is the one that he sent me that I really liked.
Yeah, that's, okay? I think that's the one I got.
And this is what actually it really looks like. He had taken a picture on his phone off the screen.
Yeah.
So the edges were darker than what this one is.
And that's what you wanted?
And, yeah, the darker one was what I really liked. So he darkened it up a little bit there. Yeah. But the first one, the picture that he took off the screen was the one I really, really
liked.
So
it's the same picture, it's just a different look.
Yes.
Okay, but you want the different look.
So, yeah, that is super sharp.
That's fair.
And so I'm hoping he'll be able to do some filters to make it look like that.
I'm sure he can.
Because that is badass.
It's I believe it's he's going with the name in Indie ICM Media, IndyCard Mafia Media. I believe that's the tentative title of the graphic.
Well, I got people that need logos for some stuff, and I'm going to send them over to him because, quite frankly, you know, he hooked this up. It looks really sharp.
I'm trying to help out on my as much as I can with the social media and everything. So we'll see where it goes. Oh man, I think we just kind of hit a wall in our pre-show.
So thanks, Eric.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks for the better. You did all the Better Live Than Dead logos, the Gear Network logos.
Yeah, my stuff looks nice.
Got it everywhere. What's up?
Nothing. Never mind.
What were we going to say?
We were talking about... Were we talking about legs? Why do I have legs in my head for some reason?
Because you always have women's legs in your head.
Well, you know what? That's true. It's probably true. I have to admit, and I've said this to you before, I walked into your house and your sister was sitting on the couch in really short shorts. She has nice legs. Bravo for your sister.
I've been told I have really long legs.
I don't look at your legs.
Do you want to look at them? I'll take my shorts off right now.
Nah, you can keep your shorts on. Okay. I appreciate that.
I'm just offering.
So it's nice of you to offer.
Okay, that's why.
I don't think we should talk about this on mic.
On air. I might get ourselves in trouble.
Exactly. We'll keep that secret to ourselves.
That's fine by me. That's fine by me.
But no, she does. She's got nice legs. Good for your sister.
I had a friend of mine send me a picture of a girl with super long legs, but she had really scaly. I mean, they were pretty damn scaly. Like, she had pencils for legs.
Right.
But I was thinking to myself, I'm like, there's nothing wrong with that. Like, the girl was probably like 6'3" because she was like 6'3", and like 5'7" of her were legs.
Right. Well, do you know who Gwendolyn Christie is?
No.
She plays Brienne on Game of Thrones.
Okay.
And have you ever watched?
Nope.
Okay, so Brienne is this real tall knight who happens to be a female, but she's in Game of Thrones. She's actually they try to make her look busted, you know,
okay,
because she's like 6'4", and she's a female knight, so they try to make her look busted. Well, outside of the Game of Thrones getup, she's actually a very attractive woman who has really long, shapely legs.
I'll tell you what, as I've gotten around civilization more, I've learned to appreciate stuff like that.
It's a good thing.
Like when I used to live out in the countryside, you didn't really care. You kind of just got what you got.
That's why I don't live in the country.
But now it's probably just more or less hanging out with you.
Right, right.
Because you're like, check this girl out. She's got real nice legs. And I'm like, I actually appreciate that. That's nice. Yes. I like that.
Good job.
Or this girl's got a fat ass, and you're like, oh, check this out. And I'm like, oh, yeah, that's nice, too.
There ain't nothing wrong with a fat ass.
Not at all.
Unless it's, like, super fat. Like, I don't want to, like, have to slap it.
Like Yokozuna?
Right, right. Yeah. I don't want to slap it with my right hand and then have to run literally to the left side to slap it. Like, that's too big.
Or do you have to grab onto the left side as you smack the right side? Because if you smack it too hard, it may smack you back.
Right, exactly.
Okay, yeah, no, thank you.
Don't want to get down with that.
Speaking of that, I guess we might as well transition. That was a terrible transition. Let's try that again. Speaking of fat asses, I think it's time for the news.
News.
That one will go down in the history books right there.
Welcome to episode 42, people.
The fat assiest transition of the podcast ever.
Absolutely.
Start off with college football. Notre Dame quarterback Everett Golson will transfer from Notre Dame. He graduated. So he'll be doing what Russell Wilson did with NC State. He'll leave. He'll go to a different school. Won't have to sit out a year because he graduated, but he has a year of eligibility left. The interesting thing about it is that sources have pinned Alabama, University of Florida, Florida State, LSU, and Texas as possible fits. So
okay.
Everett Golson is looking not only to go somewhere where he can increase his draft prospects, but also probably win as well, which is not a bad idea.
No,
I mean,
it's
look
not.
Look what Russell Wilson did. He went to Wisconsin, and I mean, obviously two different, you know, apples to oranges over here, but
right.
Russell Wilson went to Wisconsin, and they went to the Rose Bowl, and the rest is history.
Exactly. And he's done okay in the NFL.
Kind of okay. Did you actually hear, I read something on NFL.com, and I think it was about 7 o'clock this morning. The Seahawks and Russell Wilson are tens of millions of dollars off on a contract extension right now.
Really?
Apparently, Russell Wilson wants like a $420 million deal, and they want to do $480, so they want to pay him... The Seahawks want to pay Russell Wilson like Andy Dalton, and Russell Wilson wants to get paid like Aaron Rodgers, to put it in a nutshell.
That's kind of ridiculous.
So essentially, the Seahawks are first off betting that Russell Wilson will say, okay, I'll take the cheaper payday. But it seems to me as if the Seahawks management is saying, you know, hey, Russell Wilson, you know, without this really good defense and this really good offense, you wouldn't be a great quarterback.
Yeah, right.
Which we don't know. But... It's a crazy bet to take with a quarterback because you know what? Take a wild guess what happens after next season if there's no new contract signed.
He's going to another.
Russell Wilson will go to another football team. Absolutely. And he'll make
lots of money.
Stupid amounts of money.
At the same time though, you know what? I'm tired of these athletes taking these huge contracts and not thinking about what it does to the team. Like if you take smaller money, you can sign more people.
Absolutely.
You can stay good.
But here's the deal about that. Like, with, for instance, perfect example, running backs in the National Football League. You don't know how long you're going to be in the league.
Right.
You don't know how long your shelf life is.
Yeah.
Capitalize on as much money as you can when you can.
Yeah, but I feel like if you sign, like, a $50 million contract and you can't manage that $50 million, then you're doing something wrong. You know?
It's unfortunate, but that's just... That's complete...
Alvin Iverson.
Off the field stuff or off the court.
Allen Iverson,
the ice,
I mean.
Yeah, Allen Iverson's terrible with money. That's different. I'm talking on terms like of terms of, I get it. Like guys like Tom Brady, he made crap load of money, but
tons.
He said I'll take a pay cut to help the team out because he can afford it.
Right.
But then you get a guy like Russell Wilson who has been playing on a third round pick rookie salary. I think he was a third round pick, and you play on a third round pick salary for a couple years, and then you have a chance to cash in, and who knows if. You know, this could be his only contract he ever signs.
Right.
Try to cash in when you can. Set yourself up, your family up, your family's family up. Yeah, we've got ants over the place.
Well,
random ants showing up.
What, not of this bag?
Oh.
So I won't be eating this other donut.
I guess I'll close my bag up too.
Damn it.
Send the bill to Tony. Send it to Tony. Making sure my microphones didn't die because I hit the microphone thing.
That's a shame because that was a cinnamon roll donut.
Oh, man.
I was looking forward to eating that.
Moving over to NCAA now. Basketball. We're going to stay in NCAA, I should say. Basketball now. University of Florida hires Louisiana Tech head coach Mike White to the same position for the men's basketball team. White was 101-40 with Louisiana Tech. Interesting hiring, for sure. Kentucky Derby now. American Pharoah, the favorite, wins. I believe it was by like half a length.
Yes.
I texted my friend and said he won by half a horse.
half a horse.
Which I thought that was the proper terminology, but no. Apparently it's half a length.
Half a length.
Because my friend said, what the F is a half a horse? And I said, well, it's half of a horse.
It's a shame that your friend couldn't figure out what you meant, first of all.
Remember the friend, we're going to go on a deep callback here, but remember the friend in the first Gear Network All-In that couldn't change her Facebook photo?
Yes.
Her. She doesn't like horse racing because she owns horses, but she had called me at work and said, hey, you know, what are you doing? And I said, well, I'm at work, you know, stop up. And then she said, what are you doing? I said, I just watched Kentucky Derby. I know you don't care, but the horse won by half a horse. And she says, what the F is a half a horse?
That's hilarious.
I'm like, I don't know. Maybe ask your Facebook profile photo.
That's hilarious. Well, I think it's funny that she can't change her Facebook profile picture, but she understands the terminology of horse racing.
Yeah.
Which obviously says she owns horses, so that makes sense.
It's the second straight Derby win for jockey Victor Espinosa.
But honestly, if you would send me the same text message, he won by half a horse.
I said it in conversation. I didn't even say it in a text message.
Gotcha.
I said it in conversation.
I probably would have boxed you.
It's okay, because sometimes I say stupid things.
So
welcome to the story of my life. Preakness Stakes next week. We still have not had a
Triple Crown.
Should be Triple Crown winner since I think Secretariat.
Yes.
And what was it, 76?
Something like that.
Long time ago, people. Moving over to boxing now. Did you watch the fight?
Yes.
How did you watch it?
On pay-per-view.
Oh, really? I watched it through Periscope.
Yes.
Well, social media is amazing.
Yeah, I dropped $100 on it. Well, my dad dropped $100 on it.
I guess you didn't, so it's good.
I got to give him $50.
Oh, ugh. Floyd Mayweather defeats Manny Pacquiao via unanimous decision. Mayweather now 48-0. Hasn't done it yet, but Floyd says he will relinquish his championships. Also this week, he refuses to have a rematch with Manny Pacquiao, said that Pacquiao, quote, is a sore loser and a coward. Mayweather also says he won't fight Manny Pacquiao until Pacquiao admits he is the better fighter.
Yeah, well, unfortunately, after watching that fight, I don't think it's true.
Have you watched the last handful of Floyd Mayweather's fights?
Yes.
They've all played out that way.
Yeah, well, see...
He'll show up, and he'll dominate the fight by putting on stellar defense. He'll throw a couple good shots.
Right.
Which, I mean, he didn't throw a lot. He threw, compared to Pacquiao, he didn't throw a lot, but when he threw punches, he hit.
Well, see, now here's the thing. He actually threw very similar numbers to Pacquiao, and that's very un-Pacquiao-like. Watching the fight, I actually had it going into the fifth. I had it like Howard Letterman did, 2-2.
Yeah.
But somewhere in the fourth, after Pacquiao had a very good series where he actually rocked Mayweather.
Yep.
Something changed, and I could tell that he wasn't comfortable. And so he didn't throw nowhere near as many punches as he normally does. But I mean, give it to Mayweather. You know, he likes to hug some people. He did put on his tracksuit. He did run around that ring.
Yeah.
And he did land some good shots.
But that's how Floyd Mayweather has fought lately, though.
But I feel as if Pacquiao was healthy, it would have been a completely different fight.
And as you mentioned, Pacquiao being healthy, he had surgery for a torn right rotator cuff. He tried to get a shot before the fight. They wouldn't let him because he previously undisclosed the injury.
Right.
Or did not disclose the injury. And there's a possibility he could be suspended or fined by the... Nevada.
Well, Mayweather originally said that he was going to give him a fight in a year after he was healed up.
But then changed his mind because he says that Pacquiao is a sore loser and a coward.
Well, Pacquiao's not a coward. He stepped in the ring with you.
What do you think about the people suing, about people suing Manny Pacquiao for not disclosing his injury after they spent all that money on the fight?
I think it's stupid because according to his camp, they did disclose the injury. You know, so I don't know. I would like my $100 back.
I think it would be a good rematch.
Oh, if Pacquiao was healthy, the fight's completely different.
Well, I don't even think that. I don't think the fight's different. I just think it'd be more interesting.
Because I think the fight would be completely different.
I still think Floyd Mayweather's a good boxer, but he can control. Like, people hyped up that fight, but everybody that kind of, I don't even really watch boxing, but I kind of watch boxing. And when I started watching that fight four or five rounds in, I said to myself, I'm like, this is a Floyd Mayweather fight.
Yeah, but it wasn't for the first four rounds.
The way he was trying to control the fight.
Right. Well, I'm that's a Floyd Mayweather fight. Floyd Mayweather. Absolutely. But I don't think if Pacquiao had not been injured, I think it would have been a completely different fight. I think Pacquiao would have won that fight. I don't think that if you watch Mayweather in the fourth round when he's getting tagged left and right, he wasn't used to that. He wasn't expecting that. And I think if Mayweather's healthy, that's what happens consistently throughout the fight. Did you happen to watch the two undercard fights?
I did know I was at work.
Okay, so both undercard fights were actually better fights than the main fight.
Which is usually how it works. Actually, you go first.
What were you going to say?
I was going to say something about boxing tonight. But
okay. Keep going. There was a Ukrainian dude who I can't remember his name. Sorry, guys. Who fought this Puerto Rican guy, okay? The Ukrainian guy has 6 professional fights under his belt. He's already, I think, the welterweight champion it was. And the Puerto Rican dude has been dominating the Caribbean boxing scene. Just absolutely dominating it. To the point where people are saying there's no one left for him to fight because he's that good. Well, the Ukrainian guy had an amateur record of like 359 wins and like
I heard about that.
5 losses, which is just ridiculous that you fought that much as an amateur. And when he stepped into the ring, before the fight even began, Lennox Lewis said that he thought that 6 fights into his professional career that this guy was already pound for pound one of the best boxers he's ever seen because he's so technically brilliant. But they thought it was going to be a good fight because of the fact that the Puerto Rican dude has been dominating the Caribbean boxing scene and already has a title too. Yo, listen, as a Puerto Rican, I felt really bad for my countryman because he got his arse beat bad. This Ukrainian dude picked him apart, bro, and he was quick. His punches were quick. His defense was quick. He was able to go right to left extremely quickly. Dude, he would throw 3 punches, swing, but he was already like to the right of the dude. The dude would just hit empty air.
All right, sorry, we had some technical difficulties. I also have technical difficulties. I can't talk, apparently.
Yeah, this dude was disgusting. Knocked the Puerto Rican dude out in the sixth round. Do you want to pause it? Make sure we're
being recording? Yeah, I'm going to pause this really quick. Hold on 1 second, people. The podcast is being a weirdo. Never mind, I guess.
Okay, so...
The for people that aren't here, so everybody that isn't myself or Perez, I stopped and started the virtual audio cable, and Audacity froze for a second and then started to kind of choppy move second to second. So every time it went from 1 to 2 to 3 to 4, it looked like the computer program was going to freeze again.
Yeah.
But yeah, you know, boxing is kind of lost its luster.
Well, you know.
But here's the thing. Boxing fans can appreciate that fight. It was overhyped, you know, but naturally it was going to be overhyped. There's no way you could not overhype that fight.
Right.
And the last 10 fights that Mayweather's had, he's only won 2 by knockout.
Right.
Most of them are by decision.
Yeah.
Or all the other ones are by decision, I should say. I mean, I'm thinking UFC here because you can only win by knockout or decision in boxing.
Right.
You know, you can't win by submission in boxing. But, two of the last 10. Like, he doesn't...
No.
If he doesn't have to go in there and dominate you, he doesn't.
Right.
He just goes in and he'll shut you down and he'll make you fight his fight, which means you're falling right into the game plan.
Yeah.
Which means that Mayweather's going to beat you.
Yeah, I'd like to see a fight against a healthy Pacquiao. I think it'd be a different outcome, a different boxing
match. Isn't Canelo Alvarez fighting on HBO tonight, on Saturday?
I think so.
9th. He's a fun fighter to watch.
Yeah.
I hear that's going to be a very good fight to watch. Maybe I'll have to tune in. I think my parents have HBO, so maybe I'll make Dad watch boxing with me.
Tell your parents I said hello.
I certainly will. Moving over to UFC now. Anthony Showtime Pettis tears a muscle and a ligament in his right elbow in training.
That sucks.
He's out 4 to 6 months and unfortunately has to withdraw from his fight versus Miles Jury on the 25th of July. That would have been a good fight. Miles Jury is one of those up-and-coming kids who's pretty, pretty talented.
Yes.
Moving over to the PGA now. Devastating news out of golf. Tiger Woods and Lindsey Vonn announced that they broke up.
Aw.
I had to put that in there because, you know, I try to say we're entertainment podcast. There's our entertainment news for the week.
It's so sad. So sad.
I mean, it's pretty cool she's single now, but...
You know, I don't find her that good looking. She's not ugly.
I don't mind her.
I stood right next to her at the PGA Championship.
Really?
When the PGA Championship was here last year.
Wow.
In 2013.
You never told me this. Why didn't you tell me this? You should call me. I don't even know if we were.
No, we were really.
We weren't really seeing each other then, Perez.
No, we were. We were not seeing each other then. No, because the Santiago Cigar Factory.
Yeah.
We were the official cigar of the PGA Championship when they were here.
Remember that.
And so we were in the clubhouse, so we got to walk the course and stuff, and she was following Tiger, and I stood right next to her. She's surprisingly tall.
Yeah.
You know, she's okay looking. Elin, his first wife, was hot.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. So. Talking about the Players' Championship now, Kevin Na and Jerry Kelly tied for first at 8-under. Rory McIlroy tied for 13th at 4-under. Tiger Woods birdied the last hole to avoid the cut. He's tied for last, which is 61st, at E. And Jordan Spieth, the defending Masters champion, missed the cut at 3-over. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, something like he's the first Masters champion since 96 to miss the cut at the Players' Championship. Correct me if I'm wrong, please, on the tweet bots, but if I'm not mistaken, that's true. It's true. We'll just make it up anyways. You can officially cite that on Wikipedia now because it's been said in a podcast, and you can, like, I could sit here and say something about someone that's inflammatory or wrong.
Right.
And you could tag it on Wikipedia because it's in the public record now.
Okay.
You've got a place. Like, if I had a Wikipedia page and said, I have massive balls of steel, you could quote me saying Ryan once said
he has massive balls of steel
with a little number next to it. The number goes to the podcast where I say it.
Right.
Moving over to the National Hockey League now. Speaking of big balls, once I break this down to you, Perez, I think you'll get a kick out of it.
Okay.
The New Jersey Devils.
Yes.
Name ex-Pittsburgh Penguins general manager Ray Shiro the new GM of the team.
Awesome.
Mind you, for a very long time, Lou Lamoriello was the general manager of the team. Get this. Dude promotes himself to president of hockey ops, or I'm assuming that's his new gig, either president of hockey ops or president of the Devils, either way. President.
Right.
He promotes himself to president, or gets promoted to president, and then fires himself, and then hires his replacement. That's pretty badass.
That's hilarious.
I mean, it probably didn't work that way. Like, I'm sure the owner was like, hey, you know, or Lou Lamoriello said, hey, I'm ready to step down. But I'm not going to, you know, what can we do? How can I kind of retire out of this role? Well, why don't you be the president? You be the big boss. Whatever.
That's hilarious.
Chicago.
We'll promote myself.
Yeah, really, really quickly. I'm going to be promoted to chief operating podcaster.
There you go.
And then I'll hire someone to podcast for me under my name.
There you go.
Just I'm too lazy to do it. Chicago Blackhawks, Michael Roosevelt, out. I don't know if you saw this, Perez. He fractured his ankle.
Yes.
Skating.
Yes.
Ugly injury.
Uh-huh.
Hopefully he gets well soon.
Hopefully.
Detroit head coach Mike Babcock reportedly turned on an offer from the Wings to become the highest paid coach in the National Hockey League. The team officially announced yesterday they are allowing Babcock to interview with other franchises, but they are seeking, compensation is the word I'm looking for, a third-round pick, which for Buffalo Sabres fans might work out because in 2016 the Buffalo Sabres have, oh, that's right, 4 third-round picks.
Right.
But you don't know with Babcock, does he want a team that can win now? Does he want a team that's on the brink of being really good, or does he want a complete rebuild? He's already said he doesn't want a complete rebuild. So, yeah, you'd have to figure maybe a team like Edmonton or Buffalo are out.
Right.
But then again, what does he see as a complete rebuild? Does he see Buffalo as a team with, you know, a decent offseason and some good draft picks and some good free agents and maybe a couple trades? They could be a playoff contender next season? Or does he see Buffalo as a project? Because obviously a guy like him, he's not going to want a project.
No.
The only reason he wants to leave Detroit is because you're getting to the end of that time with Pavel Datsyuk and Henrik Zetterberg and guys like that and Johan Franzen, where there's no one to step in and fill those gaps that are as talented as they are. So be interesting to see how that one plays out for sure. We talked a couple weeks, I think it was last week or the week before, about Seattle getting a hockey team.
Yes, last week.
Originally, Chris Hansen, not Chris Hansen of Dateline NBC, you know, take a seat over there. Not that Chris Hansen, a different Chris Hansen. This is where I wish we had a soundboard, because if we had a soundboard, I would say Chris Hansen, and then I would hit the button where it says, why don't you take a seat right over there?
That'd
I would just keep hitting it. Chris Hansen originally had approval to build an arena in Seattle, but it had to be NBA first.
Right.
Now, Chris Hansen is open to changing that to an NHL first arena because it does not look like Seattle will be getting a basketball team anytime soon.
That's too bad.
But they're saying if they get an arena working on shortly, it could be ready by the 2018 season.
That's
and
not
it
bad.
Sounds like the NHL is ready to go to Seattle. I'm thinking if if we get an official confirmation of if we get an official confirmation of Las Vegas, I'm sure that the talks for Seattle will heat up shortly thereafter.
Vegas, baby!
A Vegas hockey team is going to be cool. The arena looks beautiful. They've the outer shell of the arena is almost done. It looks great. Talking about the playoffs now.
Playoffs.
Chicago sweeps the Minnesota Wild 4-0. They move on to the Western Conference Finals. The Tampa Bay Lightning are up 3-1 on Montreal. Washington up 3-2 on the Rangers. And Anaheim is up 3-1 on the Calgary Flames, on John's Calgary Flames. Moving over to the NBA now. Golden State, Steph Curry, named MVP. Not surprising at all.
True.
Very, 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 very good player. Washington's John Wall. 5 non-displaced fractures in his left hand and wrist. He's out,
that sucks.
Out indefinitely at this time. Now, Perez, I want you to pay attention to this one. Did you hear about Matt Barnes? Los Angeles Clippers, Matt Barnes, fined $50,000 because he reportedly, well, he yelled something at James Harden's mother. Reportedly, he told James Harden's mom to S my D, bitch.
Wow.
That's pretty funny.
And Harden didn't knock him out?
No.
You tell my mom that I'm knocking you out.
Yeah.
I'm probably going to knock you out several times. I'm probably going to knock you out.
Wake you back up.
Wake you back up, and then knock you out again.
Remind you of what you did.
Right.
And then hit you again.
Yeah. Exactly. And then I'm going to dump a whole big thing of water on your head to wake you back up again.
I would probably pee on them, wake them up by peeing on them.
No, I don't want to pee on them. Because that's
I'm
just
trying to disrespect people.
That's just real disrespectful.
Dude told your mom to SSD.
Yeah, well, you know. I don't want to pee on someone.
Levels of disrespectfulness. I guess like peeing on someone is pretty disrespectful.
And then you go take a deuce on
unless you're R. Kelly.
Right. R. Kelly likes that. So. Well, he likes peeing on people.
Yeah.
So.
Maybe he likes being peed out. I don't know.
Some people like that go to shower stuff.
Not me.
Yeah, no. I'm good. Thank you.
Yeah, I'll take a regular shower, not a golden shower.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah.
I'm good.
Anyways. Playoffs. Basketball now.
Playoffs.
Golden State and Memphis tied 1-1. Atlanta, Washington 1-1. Chicago and Cleveland. Chicago's up 2-1 on a gorgeous game-winning three.
Derek yes, Rose. And it made it all the more sweeter because earlier in the game, LeBron had dunked on Joakim Noah and started immediately talking trash to Joakim Noah.
I wanted to see those guys fight. I would pay money to see those two fight.
And so LeBron actually got teed up, which I was happy the refs teed him up. But then Joakim started jawing back at LeBron, so he got teed up also. But it was nice that someone wasn't like, oh, just going to let LeBron talk crap. So I'm glad that Derrick Rose hit that three-pointer. The bank shot. Banks were open late at night last night.
Glass.
Yes, that's what a bank shot is, off glass.
No, I said he called glass.
Yes, he called glass. So
smack you, Perez.
But anytime, dude. You say that. You say it all the time.
I'm not
but,
going to because you'll kill me.
But yeah, it was beautiful.
It was a good shot.
It was beautiful.
Plus, his reaction was priceless.
Yes, it was.
Straight faced. Everyone's freaking out.
Yes.
No big deal. Moving over. Oh no, not moving over yet. We have one more to talk about. The Los Angeles Austin Rivers up 2-1 on the Houston Rockets.
Yes.
That dude went off last night.
He did go off. He scored 15 points in the third quarter.
The entire Staples Center chanting Austin Rivers.
Yeah.
For the cast off who originally was a bust.
Right.
Has now found his way, at least in the playoffs.
They went on a 23-0 run in the third quarter, put themselves up by. They ended up winning the game by 25.
Yeah.
And
Chris Paul didn't even. He only played like 15 minutes.
Right. He made the Clippers last night made Houston look stupid.
And the Clippers have looked stupid for a long time, like the past couple years. Well, I mean, they look stupid for a long time just because they're the Clippers.
Right.
But in the past couple years in the playoffs, they've looked kind of dumb. But
they're looking good right now.
They're looking like they've kind of got it together. That was a really bad way to get to the point I was trying to make.
It's okay,
man. Like, listening back to it, I'm going to be like, you're stupid.
We understood what you're trying to say.
You're stupid for trying to make that point, you stupid face.
I still don't think they're going to the championships. I think that Golden State is a
Golden
team.
Golden State's got to get past Memphis. Memphis, when they lock down defensively, they lock down.
Yeah, I still think they're a team of destiny this year, but I think the West Championship is going to be.
You really think that Steve Kerr in his first year can win a title?
Is this his first? I think this is second.
Second, first. Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah, I think that they can win this title this year. I think
that's
they're that good.
That's a good question. Let me check and see. I don't even know.
I think he's been in the league for 3 seasons. They're looking really good.
I'm glad you don't always agree with me. That's for sure.
They're looking really good. But so are the Clips. I happen to like the Clips. I think the Clips are a really good team.
No, this is his first year. 2014, 2015.
This is his first season.
First season. He won 67 games in his first season as head coach. And remember when NBA...
You said Steph Curry, bro.
No, I said Steve Kerr.
Oh, you said Steve Kerr, didn't you? Yeah. I thought you were talking about Steph Curry.
It's okay.
Yes, but Steve Kerr, though, sure, he's a rookie coach, but he's got some titles.
Well, here's the thing, too. Remember when Steve Kerr agreed in terms to agreed in principle to become the coach of the Knicks, and then Golden State called, and he went to Golden State?
Wait, what did you?
Talk about it, hindsight being 2020.
Right.
Wow.
Yes. I get it. He's probably counting his blessings every single
day. Yeah, well, kissing Steph Curry, Klay Thompson. Everyone else in that team. I mean, the best. You have hands down the best player in basketball right now, Stephen Curry.
Yeah, the second half last night was all Clips. I mean, they made Houston look stupid.
Houston
still scored. You know,
Houston stupid because they can think they can win a championship with James Harden and Dwight Howard.
Yeah, but you know what? That's a good combo. I mean, I have finally found someone who might be worse at free throws than DeAndre Jordan and Dwight Howard, but he's horrible.
You know what? This segment has actually gone so long, we may have to shut the microphones off twice.
Wow.
I think I'm actually going to do it right now before we get into football, just because football is going to get a little heated, I think.
Okay. Awesome.
I'm just going to talk for a second. Hold on. Okay, now we're back. I love how that works. It's like a mini commercial on the podcast. Moving over to the National Football League now. A day after running back Zach Stacy openly requested a trade. After the Rams drafted Todd Gurley, Zach Stacy was traded to the New York Jets.
I would request a trade too.
The Buffalo Bills draft tight end from FSU Nick O'Leary. The reason I bring this up, a cool point to point out, because I'm, as you know, Perez, by this point of the podcast, I'm all about random, cool, random stuff. His grandfather is golf great Jack Nicklaus.
Yes.
Which is pretty cool.
I know his girlfriend.
Really?
Yes.
Also, if you go on Deadspin and look up Nick O'Leary, you can watch a crazy motorcycle accident where he
flew into a bus.
Amazing how he survived it, but he did. Crazy. He walked away. Lyle Collins. I don't even know. I honestly can't pronounce his name. Lyle Collins, I think. I apologize.
We'll just go with it.
The Collins guy from LSU.
Okay.
Signs of the Dallas Cowboys.
Yes.
So that offensive line is going to be pretty good.
Yeah, that's going to be a good offensive line.
I'm pretty sure anybody, I could run for 2,000 yards on that line. Yeah. A couple months ago, we mentioned Ed Reed was talking retirement. Well, he officially confirms he will retire. So in the same year, we lose Troy Polamalu and Ed Reed, two of the best safeties we've ever seen.
Adios.
Quarterbacks will not miss you guys.
No.
Jacksonville, first round pick, third overall pick, Dante Fowler Jr. in his first ever practice.
Practice?
First minicamp practice.
Talking about practice.
Tears his ACL.
That sucks.
Out for the season.
That sucks.
Also, Dallas owner Jerry Jones, yes, flapping his gums again. Flapping AP gums.
Okay.
He says, I would be willing to trade a 2016 first round pick, my 2016 first round pick, for a running back. So now, the gauntlet has been placed. Jerry Jones has roughly $13 million or so in cap space open. And a first-round pick he wants to get rid of. I'm thinking he probably wants Adrian Peterson really bad.
Well, didn't they just sign a running back this week?
I don't know.
Yeah, they did.
If they did, he's probably not going to be anything of merit.
No, they signed...
I don't know who they...
Yeah, they signed... what's his nuts?
That guy, yeah.
Hold on a second. Keep talking.
You got to get... it's so important he has to grab another cell phone. He's got two cell phones out right now working on a case. I think, you know, with they can probably make do with what they have. But you bring a guy like Adrian Peterson in, or just a good running back in at that point. And the Dallas Cowboys could be a Super Bowl contender. I mean, especially with that offensive line, the defense is any better at all. I mean, they were 12-4 last year, so it wasn't too bad. But you still think about it, and I mean, I don't know. I hope the Cowboys don't go to the Super Bowl. That's just me.
Yeah, they signed Darren McFadden.
They signed Darren McFadden a while ago.
Yeah, not Darren McFadden. They just signed someone this week. I saw it in the news.
Darren McFadden might run maybe like a two. But if you get like an AP with a Darren McFadden, hot damn.
Who did they sign this week? I don't know.
Let's move on. Deflategate. When you find it, let me know. Deflategate findings have been revealed. Quote, more probable than not, the New England Patriots personnel were involved in deliberate attempt to circumvent the rules. They say Tom Brady was, quote, more probable than not aware that there were inappropriate activities being taken place with the footballs. There's a report out there that Brady is to be suspended at least 2 games, if not more.
They're saying 6 to 8.
The people that I've been reading it from are more... The 6 to 8 people are usually not right. The people that... Oh, here. The people that have been reporting 6 to 8 are usually people that aren't right about things. The people reporting 2 to 4 are the people that are usually right about football things, so I'm trusting those people. So we'll say 2 to 4.
That was on ESPN this morning.
ESPN is...
Okay.
Bob Kravitz of Indianapolis, I don't know what the newspaper is, but he's usually spot on about football things. He says from people he hears, it's 2 to 4 games. I'm going to go with that.
You going to go with that?
I'm going to go with that. That's just my guess. But I don't
I think it's ridiculous.
I don't think they need to suspend him.
I don't think so either.
You can't suspend a guy if there's no actual evidence. You can't convict somebody on circumstantial evidence. You can't, no. You can't sit there and say, I hate Tom Brady. Like, I'm not a Tom Brady fan at all. But I am a fan of the game of football. And if Tom Brady being in the league makes the game better, I'm all for it. I don't care. Like, well, I enjoyed the Super Bowl last year because it was Tom Brady and the Patriots versus Russell Wilson and the Seahawks. I didn't sit there because I'm a fan of football again. Like, I can be a fan of a sport and just not like certain people.
No, I agree. And frankly,
if that makes sense,
frankly, the deflated balls didn't really have any bearing on that Colts game.
No,
you know, so
because they said at half they switched all the balls out and made sure they were reinflated. And the Patriots blew up.
They blanked them.
Yeah,
the Colts didn't score in the second half.
I mean, it's.
So they're it's talking like stripping the Super Bowl. With,
no.
You know, it's not going to happen.
It's like with Spygate, where they found smoke.
Right.
And they looked for fire. And when they found a little fire, they're going to try to make a big deal out of it. But, guys, this is something.
I think Spygate was different, though, because they were spying on people.
This is what people do in football, in sport.
Right.
You look for as much of a competitive advantage as you can until you get caught. If you don't get caught, whatever. If you do get caught. Like, how is the thing I wonder?
You know what they say.
Well, the thing I wonder is how is it, and I know someone's going to say, oh, it's because you can hold the ball better, you get a better grip. But here's the deal. Aaron Rodgers likes his balls overinflated.
Right.
So how is, because he has better grip.
Right.
So Tom Brady likes the ball a little underinflated to get better grip. It's the same exact thing. It's the same exact thing.
No, I agree.
I don't understand it at all.
I think it's stupid.
I don't get it. I think a lot of people that are pissed about Tom Brady wanting him suspended are a bunch of butthurt people.
Yes.
Like Jets fans, like Bills fans. I see a lot of Bills fans on Twitter that are like, suspend Tom Brady for the rest of his career or whatever. I'm like, shut up.
I mean, you know, we had this conversation around the Super Bowl time. All the quarterbacks that have messed around with the balls to try to get a competitive advantage. It's not like this is something new. It's not like it hasn't happened before. And the fact of the matter is, like we just said 2 minutes ago, it made no bearing on the outcome of the game.
Yeah.
They still kick the Colts' booty.
Yeah.
So, get over yourselves, people. So,
and obviously,
so,
it didn't happen.
It's not like, I mean, so the ball was deflated to, what, 10.5 PSI?
11.5.
11.5 is from 12, whatever. What?
Exactly. I'm rolling my eyes right now, yeah.
So, like you said, I'm not a fan of Tom Brady
is,
either.
Listen, Perez is a Cowboys fan.
I'm a Cowboys
that
fan.
That should tell you. Yeah. I'm a Bills fan. I've been my whole life. But here's the deal. I'm not going to sit there and be a homer and say, oh, kick Brady out of the league,
no.
Kick the Super Bowl away. Because
what'd he do?
Look at.
If you're not cheating, you're not trying.
When Tom Brady retires in 10 years, 15 years from now, people are going to say that Tom Brady was one of the best, if not the best, quarterbacks in the history of football. And
definitely his generation.
There's going to be a lot of people that are going to sit back now that don't like Tom Brady that 10 years from now are going to say, you know what? It was actually a pleasure to watch Tom Brady play quarterback.
He's a great quarterback.
That's how I feel right now. I don't like Peyton Manning. I don't like Tom Brady, mostly because they aren't on my team.
Right.
And my team has the greatest quarterback my team has had in the past 15 years has been Doug Flutie. Which, no, nothing wrong with Doug Flutie. I love Doug Flutie, but that tells you where the Bills have been.
Right.
You know, you think about it, and people sit back and they trash these guys, but, like, he's one of the greatest quarterbacks ever, and you're going to try to dig him up and throw him down because you don't like him because he's great. Because if he was a Jet, a Cowboy, a Giant, if he was anything.
Right.
Any other team, people would, you know, they wouldn't care. But because it's the Patriots, because they're so successful, because they are the New York Yankees in the National Football League, aside from the Cowboys, because the Cowboys, you know, they're just on a different, they are the Dallas Cowboys of the NFL. That's how on next level the Cowboys are. But people don't like the Patriots because,
you know, it really, so good. If you want to shut down, and I hate the Patriots, but here's the fact of the matter. Since Tom Brady became quarterback, how many Super Bowls have they won?
Four.
Enough said.
Yeah.
Enough said. Like, you can't really argue with that.
They almost had the first 19-0 season in the history of football.
Right.
They're the winningest head coach quarterback tandem in the history
of football.
The history of football.
You can't argue with that.
So what? He had a ball that was underinflated. That's like telling me... in baseball, for instance, that's like telling me that, okay, Barry Bonds' home run record shouldn't count because he's allegedly did steroids. Okay, then why is Babe Ruth the home run king, but they only faced white talent?
Right.
Why is Hank Aaron allowed to be the home run king, but he was abusing amphetamines? Because it was the time.
Right.
Like how is that okay in baseball? Like
Hank Aaron was abusing amphetamines.
What's up?
Hank Aaron was abusing amphetamines.
They used greenies all. They would make coffee with greenies in them, and they would drink amphetamine laced coffee to get hyped up. So they were there for the game. It's like players in football when they were abusing Adderall for
right
when the Seattle Seahawks were giving out free prescriptions of Adderall to their players, and you know Richard Sherman got suspended and stuff like that. You're always looking for a competitive advantage,
right?
So what, Tom Brady? His ball was half a PSI or a PSI underinflated.
Yeah, who cares?
If the ball looks underinflated, the referees need to do their job. If it took another franchise saying, look, we got the ball and the ball was underinflated, you probably should check it out, maybe the referees need to do their job.
Yeah, and you know what?
Like, I probably should have wrote down my thoughts on this topic because I'm kind of really going all over the place.
It's all good, man.
So I hope maybe John can tell me after this if I make any sense, but... I'm not trying to sound like a Tom Brady sympathizer by any means because, again, I could care less. I mean, at this point, if he retired, I would be happy.
Right.
Because there were some people that were saying, I wonder if he's going to do that because you put the NFL in a bad spot. You're a superstar. They're going to try to make a fool of you, so you're going to make a fool of them. I wouldn't mind it, but it's not going to happen.
And like I said this before. Like, you have those people who say they should have known. You could tell by feeling the ball, blah, blah, blah. I know a ton of people who played college football who have told me that.
Don't even try, Perez. You feel a lot of balls. Sorry, I had to.
My name's not Ryan Wolf, so I don't. But
that was a fifth grade comeback.
Thank you very much. Who said that you can't even really, you can't even really tell what is that little of an amount that you can't really tell. So whatever. I think it's ridiculous. I think it's stupid.
You know what? Just in a nutshell, because I kind of got my thoughts collected here. If you suspend Tom Brady, I feel like you're setting a dangerous precedent in the National Football League.
Yes.
Because, again, it's like with the domestic violence situation. I know that is apples to oranges in the most extreme sense. But you can't treat this thing like it's the Wild West. You can't go, okay, maybe. Like, out of all the 100-some days of the investigation, the 200-some pages of the paper, and all you can come up with is a probably.
Yeah, first of all, you wrote 285 pages to say, yeah, probably.
Probably, more than probable. That's what we get. And people are saying that Brady is guilty because he wouldn't hand over his text messages and his phone call records to some random guy.
Like, wouldn't either.
What does he have to prove?
First of all, he's married to Giselle.
What does he have to prove the National Football League?
Right, nothing. But I'm not handing over you my text messages on my phone because who knows what kind of stuff my supermodel wife is sending me.
Exactly. Why is it a witch hunt? That's what I want to know.
Right.
Like, why is it? Why?
Who curse?
I don't give a damn.
Move on, peoples. Move on.
Because you know what? You want to know what's going to happen? You're going to create more of a PR crap storm.
Yes.
When you suspend Tom Brady for the first two games of the season, at least, he either quits and walks away, or he goes after the league.
Well, here's what's going to happen.
Well, here. He could quit, or he could just walk away. He could sue the league. He could just say F you and take it and just completely be an asshole about it. Or the thing that's actually going to happen. Remember all the things with Adrian Peterson and Ray Rice and how the NFLPA went absolutely bonkers about it?
Yes.
Can you imagine the NFL trying to suspend Tom Brady and the PA taking it?
No.
That will not happen.
No.
Will not happen.
Or they'll suspend him and he'll come back and in the last, 12 games, 14 games, put up ungodly-like numbers.
No, you know what's going to happen. Is I almost have a feeling it's going to happen like this. They'll suspend Tom Brady two games. They'll make a big deal out of it. Big, you know, they'll pat themselves in the back. They'll say, we're the big, bad, strong, burly NFL. We don't take crap from anybody. You know, our people won't rule us. We own the players. The players don't own us. And then the PA will come after them.
Yes.
You know, they'll go into court and they'll throw some injunctions around like they did with Adrian Peterson. And then the NFL will reduce the suspension to a hefty fine.
Yeah, right.
But they'll still say, well, we still suspended him, though.
Right.
And it won't matter.
Yeah. We'll see.
The National Football League is the no fun league.
That's what I've been saying for years now.
No fun league at all.
That's exactly what I've been calling it for years.
Stop being stupid, NFL. Like, I wish the NFL would just go away sometimes. I really do.
And I love football.
I love football. I wish the NFL would just go away.
But they're just, yeah. Sometimes you're like, stop it.
Especially because I've been reading A League of Denial about the concussion. It just disgusts me.
Sorry.
It's bad. But maybe sometime you sit down and read it. It's I'm like 120 pages into the book, and I'm like, dude, like, NFL is messed up. Like, they thought concussions were like sprained ankles.
Right. That's what you said last week.
Bad news bears, man. Bad news bears. Stupid people are stupid.
That's a true story, though.
Speaking of true stories, we're at 53 minutes of this news segment.
Holy cow, we might want to take a commercial.
Going to take a commercial break. I'm sorry. When we get back here to the Better Live Than Dead podcast, we'll say hello. Brief story time. Talk baseball. Get this show on the road.
Let's do it.
Because we kind of got stuck on our own tracks there.
Yeah, no doubt.
Be right back.
While you're listening to this podcast, make sure you follow us on social media. You can follow me at WolfSHC on Twitter. You can also follow Mr. Perez at MRLG Perez. Make sure to like the podcast on Facebook. That's facebook.com/BLTD podcast. And make sure to follow Gear Network on Twitter at GERE Network.
This free and independent sportscast is made possible when you shop the Gear Network store through Amazon. Visit GearNetwork.com and click on the Amazon banner to shop through Amazon's thousands of products at great prices delivered right to your front door. Again, that's GearNetwork.com and click the Amazon banner at the top.
You're listening to Better Live Than Dead on the Gear Radio Network.
Back here on the Better Live Than Dead podcast after a lengthy news segment. But hey, we are allowed to kind of do that every so often, and, you know, we haven't had a long podcast in a couple weeks, so I guess we're going to take back what's ours, right?
That's right.
So first off, Perez.
Yes, yes.
Who do you want to say hello to today?
You know what? I think what I'm going to do is I mentioned Game of Thrones earlier. So I think I'm going to say hello to the person I talked about, Gwendolyn Christie, with the long legs who's tall. And I mentioned to you the fact that in the show they kind of make her look busted. Well, here's a picture of her in the show. She kind of looks busted.
Yeah.
Here's her outside of the show. She's a very attractive lady.
Yeah.
She's really pretty. Oh, yeah. Like I said, she's tall. She has really long legs. So, hello to Gwendolyn Christie.
Hello to her. I never watched Game of Thrones all my life.
Dude, Game of Thrones is awesome. They got this character called Daenerys. She's a queen of dragons. She likes to get naked a lot. And she's hot. So
is that why you watch the show?
One of the reasons, yes. It's actually a really good show. Like, some of the people in it are awesome. They have a imp. They have a little person. They call him an imp in the show, who's really cool. But the show itself is fun. I thoroughly enjoy Game of Thrones. And there is lots of nudity. So bravo to HBO for Game of Thrones.
Overall, it's just a good time on HBO.
It is. It truly... truly is a good time.
With that being said,
so hello, Gwendolyn Christie.
Time for story time with Mr. Perez.
Hit the bumper.
Gather round, kids. It's story time with Mr. Perez.
So, I had a story that I was going to share with you and the listening public, but I'm going to go in a different direction. I'm going to go in the news that you may need to know direction, or not need to know, quite frankly. I came across a news story the other day that made me scratch my head and go, what? So I'm going to share this news story with you.
Okay.
From the Africa Review.
Don't mind the crunching in the background. I'm grabbing my donut.
Yes, please. Go ahead. So... Zimbabwe man is in the intensive care unit at a local hospital after he was allegedly attacked by a gang of three women rapists. The man, you ready for this?
Hold on.
You ready for this? Prepare yourself. The man is believed to be the latest victim of sperm hunters who have attacked hitchhikers across the country. According to the state-owned Herald newspaper, the 25-year-old victim was kidnapped by an unidentified man and three women who held him hostage for 2 days. It was alleged that the man was looking for transport to the eastern border. He was offered a lift by the four, who was traveling in a Mercedes-Benz car. Police said the man, a suspect, was driving the vehicle while the three women were on the back seat. The driver stopped at a hotel along the highway, and the women brought some drinks. They allegedly handed one of the cans that have already been opened to the victim. It is believed that the drink was laced with an unknown drug, and the man passed out after taking it. When he regained consciousness, he discovered he was in a dark room, a cell phone, and $200 was missing. He was ordered to be intimate with one of the three women by the man's suspects, but he refused. Police say a pistol was produced and a man complied after he was given condoms. He allegedly had sex with the three women and was released the following day, dumped at a secluded place. The attackers allegedly secured the sperms from the used condoms, placing them in plastic bags and then in a cooler. For the past 2 years, stories of alleged women rapists who target hitchhikers on the highways have dominated Zimbabwe's media. The victim includes off-duty soldiers and policemen, and the women will sometimes allegedly rape the men at gunpoint. There was another story of another guy who was hitchhiking. A car pulled up with three women in it. They asked if he wanted a ride. He got in. The three women produced a shotgun, held it on him, took him to a hotel, made him drink something that was laced with something to give him an extended erection. They then repeatedly had sex with this man up to the point of orgasm, where they then would save his sperm Now, sperm in Zimbabwe for 250 milliliters is going for anywhere between $25 to $30. And they're being sold to medicine men who use the sperm in rituals. But it has to be active sperm, so that's why they're collecting it and then freezing it or putting it on ice. So yeah, in Zimbabwe, there are gangs of women running around kidnapping dudes and then forcing them to have sex for their sperm.
That is really interesting.
The guy who got held a shotgun called the cops, and he alleges that the cops then mocked him and made fun of him for reporting it to the police. Now, let's be honest with you. Let's be honest for a second. I'm not a fan of having any type of shotgun held on me, okay? But let's say I was a Zimbabwe dude, okay? And I was walking down the street, and three women pulled up and were like, "Hey, you want a ride?" And I got in the car, and then they produced a shotgun, made me drink something that gave me an extended erection, and then they had sex with me to collect my sperm several times. Do you really think I'm going to call the cops and be like, "Dude, you're never going to believe what just happened to me"?
Probably call them and say that, but you know, you don't believe what just happened, but.
No, I'm not going to call the cops. As a matter of fact, I'm probably not going to tell anyone. Oh, no, that's not true. I'm going to completely change the story around. I'm going to be like, "Yo, so I had sex with like three girls last night." At the same time.
It's interesting.
Like they took turns.
I learned something new. I never knew that. I never knew Zimbabwe was a big place for that.
Well, I didn't know anywhere in the world was a big place for that.
The thing is,
where
though,
dudes are getting raped.
Logical question here. If you know that's happening in Zimbabwe, why do you keep trying to hitchhike in Zimbabwe?
Well, you've seen Africa. I mean, not everyone has a car. Trying to get to the border. I don't know. I got nothing for you. But at the same time, I think it's interesting that there's just gangs of roaming women. There was another story I read where a guy was complaining about the fact that his wife is forcing him to have sex with condoms on so she can collect the sperm. Forcing him to have sex. It's your wife. She wants to have sex. She's using protection. And then she's selling it to the medicine man. I mean, she's not forcing you to do anything.
No.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, I don't know how long or how far $25 to $30 goes in Africa. I'm assuming if it's American money, probably pretty far if they're doing it on a regular basis. But
I should check that out. What is Zimbabwe?
But I think it's very interesting that there's just gangs of roaming women wandering Zimbabwe looking for dudes to rape so they collect their sperm.
I'm gonna look for Zimbabwe currency.
And the dude said, the one who got held up by a shotgun said that the whatever they gave him to make an erection lasted for such a long time that each woman, three women now, were able to quote unquote rape him two times each.
According here, 1 year American dollar is worth 361 Zimbabwe dollars.
Yeah, so $25-$30 isn't a bad payday over there.
I'm getting the exact amount. It's about 10,857 Zimbabwean dollar.
10,000?
About $10,000.
$25.
$30.
$30. $10,000. Listen.
Now you know why it's happening. We just CSI'd that right there.
No doubt. That's not bad. I don't live in Zimbabwe, so I don't need $25-$30. But hey, if they need sperm that bad, like, you know, I'll send them some sperm. Like, I got no problem sending them some sperm for $25-$30.
I think it might be time to send this to commercial. You're already talking about sending your sending your jizz to Zimbabwe.
I'm just saying. Like, if they need it that bad, because you know what I'm not going to do? I'm not going to have sex with my wife and then collect it and then complain about it.
I'm just going to go home tonight and start jerking off into an envelope and be like, "Honey, I got to send this to Zimbabwe."
That's right. Like, sweetie, why are you jerking off so much? Zimbabwe.
I got to give me 10 grand and then it comes back and there's a $25 in an envelope and you're right. Like, she's like, "Really? Really, Louis?"
Hey, listen, you do it enough. $25 ain't bad.
I mean, a couple times you get $100.
Yeah, so here's what I want to know. And this is going to be gross, but here's what I want to know. Okay. When they're getting raped, right, do they then tie the condom and throw it in the cooler, or are they trying to empty the column? Like, who's the person that's got to scrape the condom?
Good question.
So, yeah.
You should do like a 60 minutes thing on this now.
Yeah, I'm saying. So, yeah. So, people, if you're going to Zimbabwe out there.
Don't hitchhike.
Be careful. Unless you're looking to have sex with like three women.
That's true.
Then, you know, just make sure you wear the condoms because, you know, high AIDS rate in Africa.
Absolutely.
But I can't speak for Zimbabwe. I don't know what the rate is in Zimbabwe. But so, yeah, be careful out there, people. It's a crazy world.
Yeah, with that being said, we've learned something new today on the podcast.
Dude.
Educational.
I can't tell you how hard I was laughing as I read these stories. I'm not calling the cops, bro. I am not calling the cops.
It's a very interesting story.
Making it seem like I had the best night ever. Hey, you were supposed to be here last night. What happened? I got caught up. Three chicks needed my attention. So, you know. And, but here's the thing. If it's happening so much in Zimbabwe, you'd be like, yeah, no, three chicks needed my attention. Your friend's going to be like, oh, you got raped last night. I'm sorry.
Unbelievable. When we get back here on the Better Live Than
Dead. The same thing has happened to me.
When we get back here on the Better Live Than Dead podcast, talk baseball. A lot of stuff to talk about in baseball. Stick around. Don't hitchhike. We'll be right back.
Hey, Don, how's it going?
Living the dream. I'm actually just getting ready to do this commercial.
Oh, you mean the commercial where I tell our listeners to tune into Gear Network every week to listen to our show, Get Ready America, that one?
Yeah, John, that's the one.
They can also listen to us talk about news, sports, whatever's on our minds, that...
And a little what's on our listeners' minds, but they're just too nice to say it.
Well, that, Don, is a real humdinger. Come join us this and every week for Get Ready America exclusively on the Gear Radio Network.
And the Gear Network app.
A successful product does not become a successful product on its own. Look at the Gear Radio Network, for example. We're a prime example. We had a lot of help getting here, and we can help you get where you want to go to. Advertising rates are very low to start off here on the Gear Radio Network. Visit us at gearnetwork.com. Click on the contact link to send us an email, and we can work out the details. Again, advertise your product across all of the forums at a low, low rate here on the Gear Radio Network.
Live from the Wolf Den Studios, you are listening to Better Live Than Dead.
You want to try that one again, Perez?
Hey, we're back. Are we back? Is it official?
Looks like it.
Okay, because we just started the last segment and we were talking.
We talked a bunch of crap about John.
Yeah, when I noticed that.
Should we go back to the crap?
We could.
Should we go back to the crap? Sorry to cut you off. Or should we just leave it there for him to think that we're talking terrible things about him?
I think we should just leave it there. Let him think we're talking terrible things about him.
Although we just think that your choice in alcoholic beverages is poor.
But well, beer. Beer.
Beer.
Beer.
Beer.
Beer.
Beer.
Yeah, his choice in other stuff is pretty good because I've trained him up in the way that he should go.
Just don't drink Coors Light, John. And Red's Apple Ale, meh.
Yes.
Whatever. But I didn't turn the microphones
on. Hi, Gwendolyn Christie.
Yeah, I didn't turn the microphones on.
You did not.
But they're on now.
They are. So you can hear us again, peoples.
Amateurs. Damn amateurs.
Damn amateurs.
Major League Baseball. The New York Yankees say they will not pay Alex Rodriguez a $6 million bonus. But it's a good reason, though. I did read about it. Brian Cashman said we signed him to that marketing deal because we were going to pay him for the amount of stuff that we're going to sell, you know, shirts, hats, pins, posters, buttons, whatever, baseballs, bases, jerseys, bats, balls. I don't know. I'm repeating myself. But it's not marketable anymore. No one cares about him because he takes steroids and no one cares about a cheater.
I feel like it's not true, though.
Well, they're saying that so they can weasel their way out of it.
Right.
Someone would still buy some A-Rod memorabilia, but they're not going to sell it. If they are, I'm surprised. On Thursday, he hit .661 to move fourth all-time past Willie Mays. So that's interesting.
And you know what? Like I said before, I don't like the guy. I think he's a piece of crap.
Yep.
But even on steroids, his 661 home runs, that's still impressive.
You got to do something right.
Right. It's still impressive. Because there's a lot of guys out there who have been taking steroids who haven't hit that many.
You know what? Do you think if Barry Bonds wasn't walked 200 times a season, he would have hit 800 home runs?
Oh, probably easily. Easily. That
would have been amazing.
Easily. Absolutely. I don't think there's no way he wouldn't have.
That would have been pretty cool.
Yeah, and I don't like Barry Bonds. I think he's a piece of crap.
Oh, mostly because he is.
And even though he never got caught taking steroids, you can't tell me he didn't do steroids.
There's a cloud there. There's always a cloud there.
I mean, his head grew like five sizes.
Hey, I don't talk about bad about people with big heads, man.
Yeah, but you've always had a big head. Barry didn't. And I'm talking about the head on your shoulders. I don't care about the other one.
You're talking about Pittsburgh Barry is not San Francisco Barry.
No, Pittsburgh Barry was tiny.
Which, we've talked about this before, but I will say it again. If Pittsburgh Barry retired after Pittsburgh, he still would have been a Hall of Famer.
That's a true story.
He was phenomenal.
Yes, he was.
I don't know why I swore there a little, but...
He was. So, you know, his accomplishments, while there's a cloud, they're nonetheless impressive.
Yeah, you've got to have the hand-eye coordination. I mean, steroids don't make your hand-eye coordination.
Steroids make you stronger.
They don't make your hand-eye coordination better. They don't make you a better baseball hitter.
Right.
Just make you hit the ball farther.
Right.
That's all. Milwaukee Brewers fire manager Ron Renicki, and they named Craig Counsell their new manager.
Okay.
Ex-major leaguer Craig Counsell. Ex-brewer Craig Counsell. The Boston Red Sox think they have solved the problem by firing pitcher Juan Nieves. They have hired Carl Wells. Reportedly, he is the AAA pitching coach of the Cleveland Indians, in the Cleveland Indians organization. He has, at one point in time, Coach Sabathia, CC Sabathia, Cliff Lee, Felix Hernandez, two Cy Young awards. Obviously, he was in Seattle for a couple of years.
CC Sabathia.
I don't think that's going to solve the problem in Boston, mostly because the pitching talent is not there. But I'm interested to see how much longer they wait to pull the trigger on upgrading that staff. Like,
I still expect you guys to have a better record than the Yankees at this point in the year.
And
you don't.
It's taken time, but I think the Red Sox, I mean, they have the worst. Right now, with batting average with runners in scoring position is under 200.
Right.
In Major League history, no one's ever done that. Yeah, so the Red Sox will come around. The pitching staff will come around. Whether it's these five guys or five other guys or a mixture of five other guys, they will come around.
Right.
They may just not be good this year. Arizona signs catcher Jared Saltalamacchia to a minor league deal. He was cut from Miami after being DFA'd. No one picked him up. Tampa Bay pitcher Alex Cobb will undergo Tommy John surgery. Had a tear in his I think it was his forearm or his elbow. Something like this. Forearm strain, I think, is what he had. And tried to let it heal, and it just did nothing. Nothing happened. So he's going to undergo surgery. We're going to talk about CC Sabathia in a second, but I want to point out real quick first. Rochester Red Wings are 16-11 at this point. One game back of the Paw Sox for the lead in the International League North. They are 6-4 in their last 10 games. And a quick update on the gear guy, Jose Berrios. He still is in Chattanooga, but pitched twice since we last talked to you guys. He pitched Saturday night, May 2nd. He got the win, 6 innings pitched, 8 hits, 3 runs, all earned, 2 walks, 9 strikeouts, 98 pitches, 68 strikes. The ratio of strikes to balls is getting better. He pitched last night, Friday night, on May 8th. Got a no decision, 8 innings, 3 hits, 2 earned runs, 3 walks, 8 strikeouts, 99 pitches, 66 for strikes. You can see he's slowly but surely getting better.
Yeah, that's a good strike-to-ball ratio, and he's getting a good amount of strikeouts during the games.
He's certainly showing that he's in, and not to mention the general manager of the Twins was in Chattanooga for his start, so maybe... If he continues to have a couple more starts that are solid, maybe he could push his way up to Rochester soon.
That'd be cool.
Currently, Jose Berrios is 3-1 on the season with a 3.25 ERA for the Chattanooga Lookouts in AA. But now, a question sent in by a longtime listener, first-time caller. I believe his name is John. John C. He wants us to talk about what we think is wrong with CC Sabathia. Now, Sabathia is 0-5 this season with a 5.45 ERA in 6 starts. Now, Perez, you being the Yankees fan, what do you think is wrong with CC Sabathia?
Uh, I think he's lost his confidence. I think that there's... I think that his knee is not as well as he thinks it's supposed to be. I think he's lost some of his control. I think that he doesn't have his fastball anymore. You know, he's not blowing it past people like he used to. I think that ever since he got hurt last season, you know, he lost the weight. He's gained the weight back. I don't think he's been able to control his body like he used to.
Just to go along with your point about the fastball, his four-seam fastball, and these stats are all from pitcheffects.texasleaguers.com. His fastball, four-seam fastball average this season is 89.8 miles per hour. He's thrown 162 fastballs. He's thrown a lot of off-seam pitches, a little under. So he's certainly mixing it up very well, but he's only getting a swing and miss 2.5% of the time on his fastball. He's not fooling anybody anymore with that.
No.
The batting average for balls in play is 345, which is really bad. And the one thing I was trying to tell you about before the podcast, XFIP, which is a fielding independent, it's called fielding independent pitching. It's a new way to figure out what their ERA kind of should be. But the thing about it, it says here, the FIP is ERA over a given time if pitcher experiences league average balls in play and plus league average timing. But the XFIP is different in that they have the average home run to fly ball percentage included in it. So the FIP was somewhere around 4.5 for Sabathia, but the XFIP shows he's not really pitching bad. It's almost as if he just has a lot of bad luck right now because his XFIP is 3.85, right, which is saying that the way he's pitching right now, his ERA should be around 3.85.
Okay.
So he's just experiencing a lot of bad luck. So maybe there's some room for him to turn around, but whatever he's doing, he needs to figure out. He needs to, the thing about pitchers that it's always sad, it's always tough to watch, and it's always sad to watch, is when power pitchers start to get old.
Yeah, he's getting old.
Well, and I guess it's not so much get old as lose their fastball. Like, if you can find a guy like Mark Burley, for instance, in Toronto, he's a guy who's throwing maybe 84, 85 miles an hour fastball.
Yeah, that's slow.
He knows how to use it. He knows how to use his secondary pitches and mix everything up so
right. You
don't really know what's coming. And he can still be effective. But you get guys like Sabathia who may think, okay, yeah, my fastball is 89, but I can still get a pass this guy.
Right.
You can't.
Not today's world.
You've got to figure it out. You've got to come up with a better game plan. Like I said, he's throwing a lot more off-speed pitches, but with those off-speed pitches, you know, it's just not working. Like I said, it's probably bad luck mixed with bad prep.
Right, but he used to be able to paint the corners real well with his fastball, and he can't do that right now. And if you're not being able to get those pitches where you want them, you're going to get tagged.
Again, that's why I like a guy like Burley. You look at a guy like Mark Burley. He can control his pitching, but he has slow pitches, but he can control where the ball goes.
Right. He hasn't been able to get his fastball to get him into the two strike count. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And then you can mix it up. It's not happening.
Like I said, he's throwing a lot of off speed pitches, but his fastball is just not what it was. And at this point, he may have to become a guy who relies on his off speed stuff.
Right.
Like you look at a guy like Koji Uehara. I mean, yeah, he's a closer for the Boston Red Sox, but he uses his fastball to set up his splitter. His splitter's devastating. His fastball's maybe 88, 89 on a good day.
Right.
But he uses it to throw. He uses his fastball to set up a splitter. So maybe that's what CC Sabathia has to start doing. Use your fastball not as a primary pitch, but as a secondary pitch to set up a better pitch.
He might have to.
Set up a slider, set up a changeup, whatever it may be.
He might have to because it's just not – whatever's not working for him so far at all this season. He's, what, 0-5 this season?
0-5.
0-5, yeah.
Like I said, it looks like a lot of bad luck, but –
Yeah, because I've seen him pitch some decent games. Just not good enough to win.
That being said, thank you, John, for sending in your question to the Better Live Than Dead crew. If you want to ask us questions, feel free to shoot us a tweet on the tweet bot. tweet bots, tweet machines, whatever you want to call them. At MRLG Perez, at WolfSHC, or at BLTD Podcast. Feel free to hit us up and we will answer your questions. We'll do the hard research. We'll do the research and we will... people keep blowing up my phone.
We'll do the research, then we'll answer it for you. We'll give you what we think.
Yes. That being said, we gotta go to commercial break. I gotta call people. They keep calling me. We'll be right back to close the show up.
Do you enjoy listening to Better Live Than Dead, but you're not always by your laptop to hear it on GearNetwork.com? Not to worry, we've got you covered. Better Live Than Dead and all other Gear Network podcasts can now be heard on iHeartRadio, iTunes, in the Zune Marketplace, on SoundCloud, Spreaker, Stitcher Radio, and on TuneIn Radio. So make sure you get one of the aforementioned apps to stay up to date with the latest Gear Network podcasts.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's your boy Perez here, telling you about FanDuel's one-day fantasy baseball leagues. Every day you pick the player you want, you can pick a whole team, and play for real money against other users. FanDuel has over 20,000 one-day leagues, so joining in is never an issue. Also, there's no daily commitment, so you play whenever you want. The best part? Over $2 million in prizes every single day. And if you sign up through GearNetwork.com/FanDuel, you help support the network and keep this podcast free.
You're listening to Better Live Than Dead on the Gear Radio Network. Now, here's Perez and Ryan.
And welcome back to Better Live Than Dead. We are getting ready to wrap this show up.
It's closing time.
But as we're getting ready to wrap this show up, we have another controversy
in Zimbabwe.
Coming out of Zimbabwe. My wife is calling. Let's pause this real quick.
Commercial break, people. Hold on just a second. And we're back again from a mini commercial break.
Yes, from a mini commercial break.
Balua's got to talk to his wife.
Yes.
She's happy. So, we are happy.
Yes. So, as I was saying.
Happy wife, happy life, right?
That's right. That's a true story. We talked about what's going on in Zimbabwe with the gentlemen.
Nothing can go right in Zimbabwe right now.
Who are getting allegedly raped. Well, it seems that Miss Zimbabwe is going to have to lose her crown.
Because she doesn't know how to be an adult.
Well, dude, she was just...
Well, I guess not
it has nothing to do with that.
Don't.
How many adults send nude pics to their lovers?
You don't know how to not be with stupid people.
Right. She sent nude pics to her lover, who then leaked them to social media.
Look, if a girl sends me nudes, I'm not going to go post them on Instagram and Twitter.
No.
That's stupid.
Right.
That's real stupid.
Yes, I agree. So.
Because not only do you look like a moron, but no girl ever again is going to send you nude photos.
That's a true story.
Why would you do that?
You're just hurting yourself in
exactly.
that.
Exactly. Like you think you're being a smarty pants, but no, you're pretty dumb.
Yeah.
You are so dumb, you are really dumb.
Lots of stuff going on in Zimbabwe. It's crazy.
I can't even handle it. We're going to have like a Zimbabwe moment on the podcast every week now.
I think we should.
Speaking of Zimbabwe.
This week, Zimbabwe news.
I want to point out, thanks to John, last 4 weeks on the Gear Radio Network, we're going to give a few shout-outs to, obviously, people in the United States of America for tuning in.
Yes, yes.
Japan, the UK, Canada, Romania, and the Philippines. In the last 4 weeks, 49.8% of our listens have come from Rochester. So thank you, Rochester.
Thank you, Rochester.
8.3% from Buffalo.
If 49.7% listens to come from Rochester, I'm gonna do a cheap plug real quick.
Okay.
On East Avenue, there's a restaurant called East West, right next to Santiago Cigar Factory. They make excellent Asian-style food. Go check them out.
Okay, fair enough. Buffalo, 8.3%.
They're delicious.
Ashburn, Virginia. I don't know who you are, who's there. 6.5% of our listens come from Ashburn, Virginia. So whoever you are.
Thanks, Ashburn.
Thanks for tuning in.
Yes, appreciate that.
You keep tuning in. We appreciate it.
Absolutely.
Boiling Springs, Pennsylvania, 6%.
What's up, Boiling Springs, Pennsylvania?
The Bronx, 5.5.
South, South Bronx.
And Hilton, 4.1%.
Hilton, New York?
Yeah.
Really? What's up, Hilton, New York?
How's it going, everybody? If you want to be on that list, get more people to listen.
We appreciate the listens as it is.
We appreciate the support, continued support, 42 episodes in. Better Live Than Dead podcast, obviously support for Get Ready America, support for the soon to be debuted Beyond the Smoke.
That's right.
Support all around for the
Smoke Gear, Productions,
Gear Radio Network. I want to say thank you to John and Dawn, the presidents, owners, our bosses at the Gear Radio Network. Thanks as usual for letting us do our thing and go really long on this podcast for sure, but who cares? That's what we're here for. I want to say thank you to Brayton Wilson for doing new bumpers. As you can tell, we now have three cool voice bumpers for the podcast. Now that I'll say that you're listening to Better Live Than Dead.
Hi, Gwendolyn Christie.
So thank you for that. I want to say a special shout out to all the moms out there.
What's up, moms?
This weekend is Mother's Day.
We appreciate y'all.
To my mom specifically, love you.
To my mom, love you too. If it wasn't for moms, we wouldn't be here right now.
Exactly. And even if we were able to get here on Earth without moms, we probably wouldn't survive.
It's a true story.
That's a very true story. Besides that, though, you can't go.
I'd like to thank you, Ryan.
Thank you. Yes, I was trying to say something, but I completely forgot. So thank you for picking me up where I fell on my face, and I want to say thank you, Perez.
Yeah, no problem.
Not only for showing up and bringing donuts, but for helping me kind of clear my brain.
Yeah, no problem.
And as usual, you don't got to go home.
But you can't stay here.
We are Better Live Than Dead.
You're not.
We'll be back next week. Same time, same place.
Letter peoples.
Deeper into the hockey playoffs. Deeper into the basketball playoffs.
Let's go, Clips.
We should have more baseball news. Red Sox will probably still be bad.
Probably.
And maybe Tom Brady will be suspended. We can complain about that a little more.
I'm just waiting for the Yankees to self-destruct. We're having a okay season right now, which is kind of surprising. So I'm expecting us to start sucking anytime soon.
Regression back to the mean, right?
That's right.
With that being said,
peace.
Yes, we kind of cut it off a little early. I'm Ryan Wolf.
I'm Mr. Perez.
We're better live than dead.
You're not.
That's the second time we said it, but this time
it's all good. We mean it this time.
We're meaning it, and we're leaving. We'll see you soon. Happy Mother's Day to every mom out there.
Adios.
Podcast. Have a goal, my friend.